What's good, YouTube? It's your boy, Blue Blood Sports TV, back at y'all with another one. So, legendary, former two-time heavyweight world champion, former Olympic gold medalist, Big George Foreman, has some interesting takes regarding people continuously say that Deontay Wilder should step aside and allow the undisputed UK-British heavyweight showdown between two-time unified British heavyweight world champion Anthony Joshua and currently the WBC undefeated two-time heavyweight world champion Tyson the Gypsy King Fury. And they want former WBC reigning heavyweight world champion Deontay the Bronze Bomber Wilder to step aside, right? So that this can take place. But Big George Foreman says that they want Deontay Wilder to step aside so that he could go away. And they want Deontay Wilder to disappear. He says, if Deontay Wilder was to step aside and allow this fight to come to fruition between Fury and Joshua, he would never get an opportunity to regain the titles because nobody would give him the opportunity, right? They would avoid him. They would blackball him, right? So Big George Foreman says, the thing is, Deontay Wilder is going to honor and activate the trilogy match between himself and Tyson Fury. And he believes that Deontay Wilder is going to win the trilogy match between himself and Tyson Fury, right? So he says that, you know, that Deontay Wilder is going nowhere. He has the skill set and all the tools necessary to be successful against Tyson Fury in the trilogy match. So Big George Foreman is stating that he feels like all of the chatter coming from the media and the boxing pundits and some of these promoters, mainly Frank Warren and Eddie Hearn. Frank Warren of Queensberry Promotions and Eddie Hearn of Matchroom, right? Eddie Hearn promotes Anthony Joshua. Frank Warren promotes Tyson Fury, co-promotes. In the UK, he promotes Tyson Fury. And in the States, legendary, iconic CEO and promoter Bob Arum promotes Tyson Fury in the States, right? So he feels like all of this chatter is to get Deontay Wilder out of the way, out of the picture. And he says he advised Deontay Wilder not to step aside, not to entertain all of this chatter, all of this talk. So he's saying that they doing this because they want him out the picture because they know the problem he presents. They know he could upset the apple cart. And like I stated before, they want to put the carriage before the horse. They're announcing and promoting Tyson Fury versus Anthony Joshua. Even as of late, when Dillian White was awarded the guaranteed mandatory spot to face the winner of Fury Wilder trilogy match as the WBC mandatory challenger, they had flyers and promoted it as if with Tyson Fury and Dillian White on it, saying that Tyson Fury will be facing Dillian White next, right? So this is what they're getting at. You understand? So this is what they want to do to try to remove and dismiss Deontay Wilder. They're putting the carriage before the horse. And in doing so, putting the carriage before the horse, right? What you do is, at that point in time, is that you're dismissing and motivating Deontay Wilder. You're giving him the necessary fuel and ammunition he needs to be even more motivated outside of losing to Tyson Fury, right, in the second fight, to be successful in the trilogy match. Because he's being dismissed, he's being overlooked. And George Foreman says they understand the issue and the problem that he presents, that being Deontay Wilder, the risk that he presents, right? So they want this big money fight between Joshua and Tyson Fury. And so they're doing and trying anything possible to try to remove Deontay Wilder from the equation. George Foreman is going to advise Deontay Wilder. He's going to be giving Deontay Wilder tips, right? And George Foreman, you know, believes in Deontay Wilder, right? So with that said, you know, I'm expecting Deontay Wilder to be successful in the trilogy match. So is Big George Foreman. So I believe that Deontay Wilder, the place is set for Deontay Wilder legacy and to eat and to be even more successful, to build his legacy and his myth even more, because he's going to be such an underdog. It's already abundantly clear that they're going to favor Tyson Fury, and they want Tyson Fury to be successful and win the trilogy match, because most people want to see Tyson Fury versus Anthony Joshua, right? And they're looking at Deontay Wilder as a road bump, as a hurdle, not understanding the threat that he possesses, that he is. But are they willing to give Deontay Wilder all the opportunity to fight Anthony Joshua, should he beat Tyson Fury, like they're giving Tyson Fury, already making plans? They had a two-fight deal for 2021, and Anthony Joshua has a mandatory challenger in Kubrat Pulev, who's his IBF mandatory challenger, and Deontay Wilder is Tyson Fury's next opponent, but they're pretending as if they don't even exist, as if they're not even in an equation. So we're going to see how this all plays out. I can't wait. But that's all I got for y'all. Y'all already know what it is. It's your boy Blue, Blue Buzz Sports TV. Hate, like, comment, and subscribe. Y'all haven't subscribed? Hit the subscribe button. Hit the like button. Hit the bell icon to get all the new notification. Follow me on Instagram at Blue Buzz Sports TV, all one word. Y'all already know what it is. Shout out to the entire LDBC. Shout out to New Media. Shout out to Black Media Row. Make sure you like and share these videos. That's all I got for y'all. Peace.